Are you ready?
Yeah. Might be about the smartest, stupidest thing we've ever done right here. But
only one way to find out.
One way to find out. We drew this here. Now, I'm gonna get started now. This is the right way, isn't it?
I think so.
Drew this here once in a lifetime goat tag. And figured, oh yeah, I'll put in for the October hunt. Good idea. Then realization came in that I live in Oregon, and this is October weather. But Colton and I are going against the odds. Dead or alive, they're coming home with us.
Here we go.
Because then there says there's springs all out through here, but I don't know if there's water in them. Final destination camp. Got a fire going, got our tents up. Seen a pretty nice billy on the way in. We're going to get ready and go do a little scouting. Back there's old Colton. We're here. We're about dead center in the unit. A couple miles over that way is a destination I really want to check out, but we got a pretty nice goat just right below us here. So let's do it. Day number three. Still no contact with civilization. We've gone from goat hunt to survival mode. We're not naked and we're not afraid.
Maybe a little afraid.
A little afraid, not bad. We got a good fire going. As you can see there, it is absolutely fogged in. It's been snowing, raining, sleeting. Yeah. So much for an October goat hunt.
You probably can't hear me because the thing's on, the cover's on. We're surviving, but barely. Got a good fire going. Pretty nasty. Wind's about 40 miles an hour. It's nasty out here. Opening day, and we're stuck at camp.
It's 7:15 at night, October the 15th. We weathered a pretty bad storm today. Still going, it hasn't stopped. We're at the breaking point. It's almost, we're almost to the point where we're getting wet. Our stuff's held out as long as it can. I'm pretty impressed with it, but it's
day three of just nonstop getting beat. Just don't stop by tomorrow. We're gonna have to get out of here. It's blowing anywhere from 20 to 60, 70 mile an hour gusts. Colton's over there in his tent. As of now, he's dry. Tired. Just wet, cold, or damp. Can't tell what's dry and what's not, or what's warm and what's not, you know. Hopefully I'll be able to do more videos, because we come out alive. Boner, are you alive?
I'm alive.
He's alive.
Day four. Second day of the season. Yesterday, we were able to, we were not able. Excuse me. A little delirious here. We went through a pretty rough night. Woke up to a little snow on the ground. Wind's blowing 60, 70 miles an hour. But it's day four, and we think we can see the bog. We can see the river down there now, so probably have a good chance of maybe spotting a goat, so we're going to get moving. Probably not the worst storm I've ever been through, but the longest. I'm not sure. I don't think it's quite over with yet, but every little chance we get we can hunt, we're going to do it. So finally got everything dried out. Colton's over there taking some shots around camp with the camera. Here's our tent, our Alps tent. I gotta tell you guys, if there's anything I can say that will totally just make this trip absolutely phenomenal, is the fact that those tents right there kept us dry. I cannot
3 days straight.
For 3 days straight, and I cannot believe it. I can believe it. We put it to the test. Alps makes fantastic gear. Our packs are good. It absolutely got with it last night. I mean, like 60, 70 mile an hour wind, snow, rain, sleet, blowing, and I was as dry as could be. So pretty darn impressed.
Like a elk, you know, like you'd say, oh, that's a 6-point, or that's it's a big 4-point log. You can't really, it's really tough. I mean, I think I'm looking at it. 10 mini looks like a nice goat.
It's got big bases like a billy. I think it's Billy. It's not moving its head, it's just sitting there. Worst case scenario, if it's not nothing, we'll shoot. We can blast all that and hike back to camp.
Thank you.
So across the canyon over here, we got a pretty nice goat spotted. Right now it's probably about 600-700 yards away. Maybe a little further. We've ranged him back there at 1,000. Looks like a pretty good billy, but we need to get close enough to get a better look. We've seen some other bigger goats on out, but in some terrain that just is not safe to get to. So we're gonna head out across this canyon and see if we can get close enough on this goat, get a good shot at it.
Thank you. Hit him again. He's done, dude. He's dead.
At the same time, it's hard to explain the emotions you feel sitting next to this thing and the amount of work and effort. I don't know what other units are like as far as Billy's, but I know this one is one hell of a unit. And they call it Hell's Canyon for a reason. Three companies I want to really thank. First and foremost would be Northwest Action Works. They built these guns for us as a team. I have a 300 Win, the other guys have a 6.5 Creedmoor's. And it just takes a lot of the effort out for guys who, like myself, aren't really long range. Even though this shot wasn't a long range shot, if you can get closer, why not, you know? But today I took a pop shot down in the canyon at a rock at 700 and I would hit it dead center. So I'm pretty confident with the gun. This gun in particular has been great for us, and we've killed several deer and other animals with it. And anyway, Northwest Action Works, even if you need your gun that you have worked over to get it dialed in, get a hold of them guys. They're outstanding. Two, as you can see with the wind and weather that we've had, Alps Outdoors, our tents have kept us dry. Our packs have been comfortable. Without Alps, we couldn't have done this hunt. Our sleeping bags, everything kept us warm. And I can't even speak highly enough of how good their equipment is. Three, Rugged Maps. Derek, check him out. Makes a phenomenal waterproof, which was key. A waterproof map. It's detailed. It was able to find different drainages and cuts without any effort. Easy to read, easy to follow. Folds up nice, light in your pack. If you want it, you can even use it as a rain cover if you wanted to. But watching goats. I think it's a big one. It, even if it's not a big one, it's big enough for me. It's one I killed, and I'm happy with it. Thankfully, he wasn't all the way at the bottom of the canyon, so if I actually camp, I don't even think a few hundred yards up the ridge. It's going to be a heck of a pack out to the truck still. But beautiful animals. It's tough. They're just phenomenal to watch them walk in this terrain. It's like it's it, with ease. Thank you all for following us. As a team, we've grown. We've had our ups and downs, just like anybody else out there. But we're here, and we're together. And once again, we're going to bring this footage to you, just like it happened. Thank you. 2016 resident Rocky Mountain goat. One Rocky Mountain goat in the South Snake River Unit. Today, it's October. Crazy thing is, it's a weird feeling. I can't stress this enough. This is like the one and only time I'll ever get to cut this piece of paper. Yesterday was the 15th. Today's the 16th, right?
No, wait.
No. Don't do that. There it is. Tagged. Get in the light. We're back at camp. Where's that bottle at?
Here you go.
We got us our celebration Southern Comfort right there. We got a good fire. The Billy's about 3/4 of a mile that way. Maybe give or take a little bit. What an awesome day. It's cold out, but we've got a good fire going. We're just gonna hang out here, get up tomorrow and get him all finished, packed out. And hunt of a lifetime, man, but I'll tell you what, you gotta want this bad. And
it's not easy.
No, not at all. Today we wanted it. Anyway, good fire. Yeah. Bottle of whiskey. Cough syrup. We got you.
Celebrate.
We got you. Pooners, Booners, and Bobby's Biggins here. And you got anything to say, yeah, Pooner?
Hell of a day.
Hell of a day. That's right. Hell of a day. And got it on film.
And, it's gonna be epic too.
Yeah, it is. Anyway.
Wait for it.
Later. Week's episodes, Pooners, Booners, and Bobby Biggins. We're hunting mountain goats here in Hell's Canyon.